In this video, we are going to talk about your gut health and autoimmune disorders. So autoimmune disorders are not very well understood. However, there are certain evidences that point to its association with your gut health. Also, because there are certain traits, like women have more chances of getting autoimmune disorders than men, and it is linked to X chromosome, FOXP3 gene, that is located on X chromosome. And also the same defect is seen in autoimmune enteropathy. So there is some evidence that show that it could be related to your gut health. So keep in mind that your gut is the world of bacteria, and there is intestinal barrier that separates the bacterial world from your own defense system, that is your own blood. So there is intestinal barrier, and in your gut bacteria resides, and there are good bacteria, bad bacteria. But in an healthy individual, the dominance of good bacteria is always more over bad bacteria, and good bacteria also play a significant role in keeping your gut healthy. So what happens that whenever, due to any problem with your gut, the integrity or there is increased disturbances in the intestinal barrier, then certain microorganism, toxins, or certain antigens can gain access and enter your blood, and that can cause decrease in your immunological tolerance, leading to development of autoimmune disorders. So if you see the protective layers that in intestinal barrier and how it keeps certain pathogens, certain antigens from entering into the bloodstream, you will understand how it can be very, very important to prevent autoimmune disorders. So there is a protective mucus, and these are your enterocytes, and these are the villi, and these are tight junctions. So these all play a significant role in preventing toxins from entering into your bloodstream and thereby causing development of autoimmune disorders. So what happens that when your mucus, this is the mucus layer that is protective, and when certain bad bacteria, especially mucus eating bacteria, gain access and starts to eat mucus, they can cause damage to your intestine and thereby leading to autoimmune disorders. So what causes development of mucus eating bacteria? It is low fiber. So those person who eat foods which are low in fiber are more prone to develop mucus eating bacteria inside their gut and can cause development of autoimmune disorders. The first is mucus. So eat fiber rich foods from your vegetables, fruits. So fiber is very important. Then second is here, these are villi. And in genetically predisposed individual, what will happen that certain proteins, especially gluten, can cause the destruction, and this can again predispose you. And so third thing here is tight junction. So these are tight junctions. So these are nothing but these are proteins at the apex of the enterocytes. So these are the proteins. So they do not allow pathogens or toxins to seep into your blood. So these are very important. So how to keep this intact? So since they are transmembrane protein, you have to eat foods which are rich sources of amino acids. Then flavonoids are very important. So it is seen that for tight junctions to adhere closely and prevent the leakage of toxins, you need certain flavonoids. Quercetin is very important. Quercetin, then berberine, and eating foods which are anti-inflammatory, especially turmeric. So these food will help in maintaining your tight junctions. and preventing it from falling apart. So these foods are very important. Foods rich in amino acids, quercetin, berberin, turmeric. Now there is intestinal epithelium. So to maintain the integrity of intestinal epithelium, what you need is vitamin A. And to increase the formation of tight junctions, what you need vitamin D. So you can take cod liver oil for proper functioning of these tight junctions, vitamin A and vitamin D. Then what causes increased permeability of the intestine? First is obesity. So you have to lose weight in a healthy way to prevent increased intestinal permeability and seepage of toxins into the host defense. Then second important thing is lifestyle. So a diet which is high in sugar, processed food, junk food, unhealthy fat, unhealthy oils, all these can cause increased intestinal permeability, thereby predisposing you to get autoimmune disorders. So you have to avoid eating such foods, processed food. Then avoid alcohol, smoking. These are also bad for your intestine because they increase the intestinal permeability. Then third is stress. Stress is another important thing that can cause increase in intestinal permeability and can lead to autoimmune disorders. So vitamin D and vitamin A to maintain the structural integrity, high quality proteins to maintain the tight junctions, avoiding foods like gluten that can cause destruction of the villi, and eating fiber rich food so that you do not allow bacteria eating mucus eating bacteria to gain access. Then there is role of probiotics. So probiotics, especially lactobacillus and bifidobacterium longum, these two strains of probiotics are extremely important to prevent leaky gut and to prevent increased intestinal permeability. So you need to avoid gluten, you need to avoid sugars, processed food, unhealthy oils, partially hydrogenated oils. You need to eat high quality protein, lots of green leafy vegetables, fruits for flavonoids and phenolic compounds. Turmeric is very important. Then take cod liver oil for vitamin A, vitamin D, probiotics and fiber. So this is how you can prevent or even reverse, following this protocol, you can even reverse certain autoimmune disorders. Thank you.